मिलितं येन तस्मै श्री गुरुवे नमः। श्री चैतन्य मनोभीष्टं स्थापितं येन भूतले स्वयं रूप कदा मह्यं ददाति स्वपदान्तिकम्। वन्देऽहं श्रीगुरु श्रीयुतपदकमलं श्रीगुरुं वैष्णवांश श्रीरूपं साग्रजातं सहगणरघुनाथान्वितं तं सजीवं साद्वैतं सावधूतं श्रीराधा कृष्णपदा सहगणललिता श्रीविशाखान्विताश्च नम ओं विष्णुपादाय कृष्णपृष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्तिवेदान्तस्वामिनिति नामिने। नमस्ते सारस्वते देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेष शून्यवादी पाश्चात्य देश तारिणे। हे कृष्णा करुणा सिंधु दीनबंधु जगतपते गोपेश गोपिका कांत राधा कांत नमस्तुते। तप्त कांचन गौरांगी राधे वृंदावनेश्वरी वृषभानुसुते देवी प्रणमामि हरि प्रिये। वाञ्छाकल्पतरुभ्यः कृपासिन्धुभ्यः च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः। जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौर भक्त वृंदा। हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 रामा राम राम हरे 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 कृष्णा। So welcome back to the Saturday and Sunday series on Sri Harinam Chintamani. Yesterday, because of some emergency thing, we could not have the class. So we have been discussing in the last class. Oh, audio is not clear. Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna. It's not clear. Okay. Let me try this. Is it clear now? I hope you are able to hear now. Okay, fine. So in the last class, we begin with chapter 9, which is a very important philosophical chapter, which speaks about the the fifth offense, I think it is. Fifth or the sixth offense, I don't recollect it is. Namno balad yasya hi papa buddhir. Committing sin on the strength of the holy name. Firstly, Haridas Thakur speaks about the glories of the holy name in verses 2 to 13. How powerful and potent and glorious is the holy names. We saw these verses. And then Haridas Thakur speaks about that so glorious is the holy name that it destroys all sin. Then he comes to the topic in verses 14 to 20 about previous sin and its residue are destroyed quickly. So the previous propensity to commit sin is gradually destroyed. It becomes less and less, and gradually he becomes pure. There is some time between the sinful and the sinless life. The sinful life is before taking to Krishna consciousness, and the sinless life is a life where, while practicing our spiritual life, anarth nivritti is still happening, and there are chances that you might accidentally come under the impressions and commit sins. But after you cross anarth nivritti and nishta, practically there is no chance you might commit sin. But definitely at the stage of nishta, you are completely cleared of all purva papa and punya. So that can be called as a sinless life. And the sinful life is before taking to Krishna consciousness. So between these two stages, there is a gandha, scent of sin lingers. So this is how it mentions. But by association with holy name, purity will come and all the residue of sinful proclivity quickly will go away. Because Krishna has promised, Kaunteya Pratijani Name Bhakta Pranashyati. And then Bhaktivinoda Thakur goes on to explain that a devotee who accidentally sins need not perform prashchit. There is no need for him to perform prashchit. And we discussed how Prabhupada in 9.32 mentions that there is no need for a devotee to atone, because the process of atonement is there in the chanting. He has to just continue his chanting. And then he mentions that the momentary sins do not count. He's diving in the nectar of the holy name and he doesn't meet misfortune. Now, from text 23 to 24 onwards, we will begin our discussion today. Very interesting discussion. How systematically Bhaktivinoda Thakur has now developed the topic. And now he will speak in or we lost the connection. Kintu yadi, however, if he deliberately commits sin on the strength of the holy name. Kono jana nama kari bale, on the strength of the holy name. Achare nutan paap, he commits new sin. A mischief monger trying to cheat the holy name attains grief, fear, and even death because of his offenses to the holy name. Se kevala kapatata kari ashray, nama pradapai shok. Shok means grief, vritti. Vritti means death, vritya, and bhai, fear. If he does this kind of an activity, then this is what he is going to get. Now he comes to what is this deliberate sin. If deliberate, then he Ache Bhakti Shastra Marme. Accidental and deliberate actions are completely different. This truth is revealed in the heart of devotional scriptures, Bhakti Shastras. So in the Bhakti Shastras, these have been revealed that there is difference between accidental and deliberate actions. There is a footnote. Let us see first the footnote. Sinful acts are of two kinds, accidental and deliberate. When, with a steady mind, one carefully thinks, I will do this one sin, that is deliberate sin. The two kinds of sins are very different. So here in the PowerPoint, I have brought this out. Firstly, that sin through chanting. If a devotee commits sin with no fear of reaction because of the power of the holy name to remove reactions, then it is apraad. This is what is being mentioned. Even thinking of committing such a sin has no atonement. Committing a sin will bring unlimited suffering. Then the example is, if a person hears that chanting the name even in Namabhas releases one from the effects of sin committing in 10 million lifetimes, he then disguises himself as a Vaishnava and chants while intending to commit more sin without fear of punishment. Without fear of punishment. So this is something, you know, deliberate. It is not accidental. Deliberate means intelligently you plan that I will chant now and then go and commit sin. So this is a very, very serious offense. There was one question which was asked by Birendra Yadav Prabhuji. Yes, Prabhuji.
Hare Krishna, Prabhuji. Dandat Pranam. Prabhuji, just clarification, Prabhuji, that this so-called Sahajiya devotee.
The audio got cut off from your side. Once again, you can. Hari Bol. Hare Krishna.
Audible?
Yeah, now it is audible.
Prabhuji, just clarification that after Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, this so-called Sahajiya devotees in Bangladesh, they would be falling in this category?
Namno baladi yasya papa buddhi. Can't exactly say because we don't know what is their intention when they chant Hare Krishna. What is their intention? So you cannot specifically say that Sahajiyas can fall in the category because you'll have to see, you know, or some might be ignorant and they might be chanting Hare Krishna and trying to go into these higher levels for which they have adhikar. But chanting Hare Krishna is purifying them, and if they come with the association of a devotee and get sambandhyan, he might come to take the path of real Vaishnavism. So we cannot say exactly whether it will come in that category. Whereas for devotees who are chanting the Hare Krishna Mahamantra, who regularly recite the 10 offenses to the holy name and who know about it, if they commit sin deliberately, thinking the mentality is what? I will commit this sin and then chant and become free from that sin. With this kind of a mentality, if you commit sin, then it is a very severe offense to the holy name. Okay. Now, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, in text 26 to 29, a human being in the material world who commits a sin should repent anutap and perform atonement prashchit. Samsari manav, that means human being in this material world who has not taken up to the path of bhakti. Kintu nama bale yadi papa kare mati prashchit nahi tara bada ai durgati. However, if a person commits sin on the strength of the chanting, he is not eligible to perform atonement. His future is very inauspicious. So this is the difference between the bhakti path and the karma kanda path. In the karma kanda, when sin is committed, you have to repent and you have to do atonement. In the bhakti path, if you commit namabala yadi pap, you cannot do any atonement. And his future is very, very inauspicious. Bahu yama yatanadi paila o tara sei aparada haitena hoya udhara. Even after many punishments of Yamraj, he is not delivered from his offense. He's not delivered from his offense. One who does like this. Papamati matra hoy ei rupa yantrana papachara yata dosha tara ki ganana. Even if he thinks of committing a sin in that way, he will be punished. What can measure his punishment if he acts? So here is a very, very important point for devotees to understand that there is a difference in aparad and pap. In the previous ages, if one in his mind also would think of committing a sin, he would get implicated in it and he would suffer the reactions. But in Kali Yuga, this doesn't happen. In Kali Yuga, Lord is very merciful. Everyone at every moment is thinking of committing sin. So what would be the situation if they keep on getting those reactions? So Kali Yuga, this is exempted. On the other hand, if anyone thinks about pious activities of doing in the mind, although he might not physically do it, still he gets the full benefit. Like one can think of donating 10,000 cows to Lord Krishna's temple. So he gets all the spiritual punya for that. But if one thinks of committing a sin also, on the strength of the holy name, he will be punished. And what to speak of committing the sin? If he actually now commits a sin based on the strength of the holy name, what kind of punishment will be there for him? Can we imagine that? So, Vaishnava aparad also is not just physical aparad of abusing the Vaishnava, criticizing with him with bad words, finding fault with him, speaking about him. But in the mind also, if we think bad about certain Vaishnava, then also we commit Vaishnava aparad at a mental level. So there can be Vaishnava aparad at the mental level, at the mind, at the verbal level, and at the physical level. And the gravity is deeper and deeper and stronger from the mental to the verbal to the physical. So this is how Bhaktivinoda Thakur is making that point clear. Now, 30 to 34, Bhaktivinoda Thakur mentions a cheater who trusts the holy name and then sins is renounced like the monkeys, Markata Vairag. Shastra suniyache nama yata papa hare koti janma mahapapi karite na pare. In the scriptures, it is heard that the holy name destroys more sins than the great sinner can commit in many millions of lives. Koti janma mahapapi karite na pare. He can commit unlimited sins for millions of births, but the holy name can destroy all these sins and even more sins. Pancha vidha papa mahapataka avadi namabhase yaya shastra gaya niravadi. The five kinds of sin, including even the gravest of the sins, are counteracted by namabhas chanting of the holy name. This the scriptures say again and again. This is the scriptures say again and again. So there are these five kinds of sins which are committed, especially in home. This is called as Panch Mahapapa, or Panch Mahayagya also is done for this. Like while brooming the home, or while boiling water, or by using the grinding mortar, all these, you know, there are these five kinds which is mentioned. Not only that, even the gravest of the sins, all can be counteracted by Namabhas. Seita bharasakari pravanchaka jana shatata kariyanama karaya grahana. That is why the cheats and imposters are attracted to chanting the holy name. So these are like cheats and imposters, like thieves who know that I'll chant and I'll commit sin. Kashtera samsara chadi vairagira veshya kanaka kamini ase fire deshe deshe. Renouncing troublesome grahastha life, he may accept the garments of a sannyasi. Kashtera samsar. Kashtera samsar is a grahastha life. Chadi, living. Vairagira vesh, he wears a dress of a vairagi. Lusting after women and money, he may travel from place to place. Now Haridas Thakur says, Tumi to bole ache prabhu markata vairagi kamini sambhashi fire dharma graha tyagi. O Lord, you have called such a person a markata vairagi. Tumi to bole na prabhu markata vairagi kamini sambhashi. Pretending to be a sannyasi, he likes spending time chatting with women. So where has Chaitanya Mahaprabhu spoken like this? As Haridas Thakur is saying, where in the Chaitanya Charitamrita Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has spoken like this? Anyone knows? Has anyone some idea about it, where he has spoken like this? Can raise your hands. Where has he spoken? It is there in context to Chota Haridas, Chota Haridas pastime. In relation to Chota Haridas, Lord Chaitanya criticized such persons, calling them Markat Vairagi, monkey sannyasi. This is described in the Chaitanya Charitamrita. A sannyasi who talks with women is a Markat Vairagi, is a Markat Vairagi. Now, from text 35 to 37, Bhaktivinoda Thakur mentions, persons who do not sincerely take shelter of the holy name cannot avoid this offense. Vairagira chale keha grihe kate kala sambhasya na hoya sab vishvera janjala. Such a person pretends to be a sannyasi, but in truth he lives like a grahastha. They must be avoided as they are nothing but a disturbance to the whole world. Grihe thako vaneyo itate nahi dosh nishpape karuk nama paya santosh. A person may live as a grahastha, grihe thako, or he may go to the forest and live as a sannyasi, vane thako. Either way, he is not at fault. He should live a sinless life, chant the holy name, and be happy. Footnote: a devotee who shelter of the holy name may live as a grahastha at home, or he may live as a sannyasi in the forest. There is no difference. And why not? If one's grahastha life is favorable for chanting the holy name, then the sannyas ashram may wait. But if his grahastha life is not favorable for chanting the holy name, a Vaishnava should leave home and renounce grahastha life. So Prabhupada also in the Bhagavad Gita 13.8 to 12, in the purport also he similarly makes the same point. Then Bhaktivinoda Thakur mentions, Nama bale papamati maha aparad tahata majila hoy bhakti tatva bhad. To have the idea of committing sin under the shelter of the holy name is a great offense which will block the path of bhakti. Bhakti tatve bhad. So, to think of committing sin on the holy name is itself a great offense. What to committing? It's a great offense. So one should be very careful and avoid this. Now, Bhaktivinoda Thakur in text 38 and 39 mentions, by associating with cheaters, a person who's chanting his namabhas will commit this offense. So who commits this offense of Namo Baladez Papa Busi? It is associating with these kind of cheaters. Even in the Vaishnava circles, there can be some cheaters, and associating with them, we might get influence. So that is what Bhaktivinoda Thakur is going to speak. Namabhasi janira kusanga yadi hoy tabe e aparada ghatibe nishchay. If they associate with bad people, persons whose chanting is namabhas will eventually commit this offense. Ghatibe nishchay. They will definitely commit this offense. If these people who are chanting, although they are chanting at namabhas, but they do all these evil acts of committing sin and chanting the holy name. If we associate with such people, then there is chance of committing the sin. Shuddha namudaya yara ridhaya hoibe e nama aparad tarana ghatibe. When pure chanting of the holy name, Shuddha nam, rises in the heart, ridhaya hoibe, yara ridhaya hoibe, the devotee will not commit this offense. So only those who are chanting Shuddha Nam, they will never commit this offense, because they have crossed that sinless stage. From the sinful, they have crossed the sinless stage. They will never commit offense. So even one who is chanting at Namabhas should be very careful about this offense. So that is what he is going to mention now. Now text 40 to 43, Bhaktivinoda Thakur mentions, the 10 offenses do not touch anyone who purely takes shelter of the holy name. This is what was the theme in the last verse, and he now elaborates here. Shuddha nama ashrita jane aparada dasha kono rupe kono kale nakare parasha. The 10 offenses do not touch any way or any time touch anyone who purely takes the shelter of the holy name. So one who is chanting Shuddha nama, these 10 offenses do not touch him in any way, at any time. So that means, what is the lesson we can learn from here? Anyone can raise your hand and answer. What is the verse, when this verse, Bhaktivinoda Thakur is saying the 10 offenses do not touch in any way or any time, anyone who purely chants the shelter of the holy name. Yes, Birendra Yadav Prabhuji.
Hare Krishna Prabhuji.
Oh, again the audio is not clear. Hare Krishna. Okay. Yeah. Okay, so there is some problem with audio. It means that until we come to the stage of pure chanting, there is always a risk that we might commit the 10 offenses. And especially this offense also. Nama shrita jane nama sada raksha kare aparada kabutara na hoite pare. The holy name protects anyone who takes shelter of the holy name. Such person never commits offenses. Yata dina shuddha nam na hoya udaye tata dina aparad akramena bhaya. During the days when pure chanting of the holy name has not yet arisen, one will still be threatened by the danger of committing the offense. Yata dina shuddha nam na hoy udaye. When the pure chanting has still not arisen, there is always a threat of committing this offense. So how much we should be careful about these 10 offenses. That is why he concludes, Atha eva namabhasi yadi bala chai namabale papa buddhi hoite palai. Therefore, Atha eva, if one's chanting is namabhas, namabhas yadi bala chai, one should flee from the idea of committing sin on the strength of the chanting of the holy name. So if one is chanting on the Namabas platform, he should free himself from the idea of committing sin on the strength of the holy name. So what to speak on chanting at the level of Namaprad? Even in the level of chanting of Namabas, there is this chance we may commit this offense. But when we come to Shuddhanam, there is no chance that we will commit this offense. 44 to 48. For how many days must one struggle to avoid the offense? Now, when we said, said that till, you know, there is chance. Now, how many days? Let us see what Bhaktivinoda Thakur is saying. Shuddha namashrita jana sangha baladhari aparadasa tarkata sarvada achari. Drawing strength from the association of devotees who purely chant the holy name, Shuddha Namashrita Jana, one should take great care to avoid offenses. So how many days will depend on how much you associate with those who are taking shelter of Shuddha Nam and their association. And you should take dhari, bala dhari, great determination, with great care, one should avoid this offense. Strength from the association with devotees means strength from association with pure Vaishnavas. So that's how he clarifies. Shuddha nama yara muke tara drida mana Krishna haite vichalita nahi ekashana. When the pure chanting of the holy name appears in one's mouth, the heart becomes passionately attached to Lord Krishna. That heart will never leave Lord Krishna even for a single moment. Surrender to the holy name. He must be very careful or fearful of committing offenses. Vishesha yatane papa buddhi dhura kari aharnishi mukhe boli beke hari hari. Especially vishesha, one should throw far away the offense of committing the sin on the strength of the chanting. Papa buddhi dhura kari. Day and night he should chant hari hari. Ahar nishi mukhe boli me hari hari. Shri Guru Kripaya hobe susambandh gyan Krishna bhakti Krishna naam tahat vidhan. By the spiritual master's mercy, one will eventually attain true knowledge of one's relationship with Lord Krishna. This knowledge will reveal the science of pure devotion and the pure holy name. Now, the last part. Now, there is some slide which I have to show maybe. Now, the cause of Namabas we saw, the cause of this offense we saw is bad association during the Namama stage. And one at Shuddhanam stage does not commit this offense. This also we saw. And then what was the remedy given? Associate with pure Vaishnavas who will protect one from this offense. One at Namabas should constantly chant and with grace of Guru and Sambandhigyan, remove the anarthas and come to Shuddhanam. So that is the solution which is mentioned here. So last few verses are there. Let us take up that. Remedy I have already spoken now. Sorry. Yadapi pramade nama bale papa buddhi shuddha vaishnavara sange karitara shuddhi. If one foolishly commits sin on the strength of the chanting of one should purify himself by staying in the association of pure Vaishnavas. So that was also mentioned in the slides here, that associate with pure Vaishnavas who will protect you from this offense. Papa spruha bata pad पते आसी धरे विशुद्ध वैष्णव गण पत रक्षा करे. सिंफुल डिजायर्स आर लाइक हाईवे मैन दैट ले इन वेट. प्योर वैष्णवज आर गार्ड्स दैट प्रोटेक्ट ट्रेवलर्स ऑन द हाईवे. उच्च स्वरे ढाकी रक्षा करे नाम धरी पलायबे बत पाद आसीबे प्रहरी. By chanting the holy name, one loudly calls for the guards. Pure devotees or Vaishnavas are like guards. One loudly calls for the guards. The guards come and the robbers flee. So beautifully, Bhaktivinoda Thakur has brought out this point here. Now, in the Manashiksha, the Manashiksha is a very, very important work of Srila Raghunath Das Goswami. In Manashiksha, Raghunath Das Goswami has mentioned how to purify the anarthas in the mind, how the anartha nivritti can happen with artha pravritti. And it is a beautiful work, especially to work on the internal sins which hide deeply in the form of lust, anger, greed, pride, envy, pratishta, and duplicity. So each of the verses, he explains these verses in beautiful composition and gives the solution. Bhaktivinoda Thakur is actually referring to one of these verses, which is text 5 of Manashiksha. Asa cheshta kashta prada vikat pashali bhiriha prakamyam kamadi prakat pata pati vetikare gale badvahane hamiti bakabit vartma pagane gurutvam फुटकारान अवति सयता त्वां मन इत. असत चेष्टा मीन्स विकेड एक्टिविटीज लाइक द एक्टिविटीज ऑफ कमिटिंग सिन. कष्टप्रद मीन्स दे गिव अस पेन. दे आर विकट, दे आर हॉरिबल एंड दे आर लाइक पाश, दे आर लाइक मेनी रोप्स इह. And prakamyam kamadi, and they all begin by willing that I will commit this sin. It can be pap or it can be also this seventh offense which is being mentioned. They begin with kamadi. So kama, krodha, lobha, mada, matsarya. So if we feel envy towards a Vaishnava, and feeling envy is pap, and if it is feeling envy towards a materialist person, it is pap. But feeling envy towards a Vaishnava is aparad. And feeling envy, now you act to, you know, cause harm to that Vaishnava, to harm to that Vaishnava. So this is what they begin with, kamadi. So even for a devotee who is practicing spiritual life, he is still not free from sin. Sometimes the vasanas in the form of kama might arise and propel you to commit sinful activities under the force of vasanas. So when all these things happen, they prakat, they manifest in the heart. Pate pati means, actually, these are like highway men. They are highway men who are like highway robbers. In fact, very beautifully in the Manashiksha, okay, I have the book where it is very nicely shown graphically. I'm just looking for it. Let me see. No, I'm looking for the book. Very graphically it is described in his book. So, these are like highway robbers. They are highway robbers. So the path of bhakti is a straight highway path, which is self-illuminated. And in this self-illuminated path of bhakti, these kamadi, they are like the six highway robbers. Vati kare gale badwa. These highway robbers catch the devotee and, you know, they tie ropes to his neck. So when these, it happens like this, what you should do? Hanne ham means I'm about to die. They're trying to kill me. This kamadi, or the offense to commit sin, it is killing me. So I should first call out, Hanne ham. And we should call out to whom? Baka bid vartmapa gane. We should call Krishna, the killer of Baka demon. Vartmapa gane, the pure devotees. We should not call out Krishna. When Kama troubles us, we should not call Krishna. When Kama troubles us, we should call Krishna's pure devotees. Because Krishna's pure devotees are like the guards on the highway robbers, on the highway, to, you know, keep guard against the robbers. And how we should call? Kurutvam futkarana. You should scream out, please protect me, oh my mind, do this. Kurutvam futkarana. So this is what also in the Manashiksha is what Bhaktivinoda Thakur is mentioning. Uchaswara daki. Daki means call out. Rakshakara namadhari. Call out, oh guards, the pure devotees, Bhakavid, please come and protect me. And moment you sincerely call out, futkarana. This word is used in the Manashiksha as futkarana. Futkarana means cry out. You should cry out from the deepest core of your heart. Lust is attacking me. Pride is attacking me. When you call out like this, then what happens? Krishna hears that cry and Krishna will send his pure devotees to protect that devotee. We should call out not Krishna, but you should call out pure devotees of Krishna, and Krishna will arrange that the pure devotees come for our rescue. So this is a very beautiful verse in the Manashiksha, reflecting on how to handle these inner anarthas in the form of calm. And also the same principle Bhaktivinoda Thakur is explaining here in Harinam Chintamani, how to become free from this Nama Bala Desi Papa Buddhi, which is much, much severe in gravity compared to Pap. It is because this is Aparad. Aparad is very grievous. Adhare bolibe bhoy, nahi kare bhoy, amita rakshita tava, suno mahashay. Chant the holy name with love. Adhare bolibe. O my brothers, bhoy, do not fear. Nahi kara bhai. Amita rakshakatava. The Supreme Lord Himself has said, I will be your protector. Suno mahashaya. No? Kevala Vaishnava pada dasya vrata yar harinama chintamani paye se char. A person who, even though he is worthless like a pile of ashes, has taken a vow to serve the Vaishnava's feet, sings this Harinam Chintamani. So what a genuine humility Bhaktivinoda Thakur is mentioning in this last verse. A person who, even though he is a worthless pile of ashes, Pada Dasa Vratayar, Pai Se Char. Char is, you know, pile of ashes. But he has taken the vow to serve the Vaishnava's feet. Vaishnava Pada Dasa Vratayar sings this Harinam Chintamani. Gaye Shri Harinam Chintamani. Iti Shri Hari Nama Chintamani Nama Bale Papa Buddhir Nama Navama Paricheda. So that's how Bhaktivinoda Thakur ends the discussion on Sri Harinam Chintamani's ninth chapter, which is Namabale Papa Buddhi. So the next chapter is chapter 10, Instructing the Glories of the Holy Name to the Faithless, to the Ashraddha. So that we will take up in the next class. Okay, so there are some questions. Yes, Virendra Yadav Prabhuji.
Hare Krishna Prabhuji, Dhanat Pranam. Prabhuji, you mentioned in verse 31, this five kinds.
Oh, there is again some problem with the audio. Can you once again try? I will unmute you.
Hare Krishna Prabhuji, with reference to verse 31, you mentioned this five kinds of sin. If you can just elaborate, Prabhuji, these five kinds of sin.
The five kinds of sin are mentioned in the Bhagavad Gita. I don't recollect where exactly it is mentioned. I'm just looking for it. The five kinds of sin are called as Pancha Maha Yagya. This yagyas which are done to counteract the five kinds of sin. And Smriti Shastras mention what are these five kinds of sin. It is mentioned in the Smriti Shastras that, So in Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur's commentary to 3.12, Ishtan Bhogani Hi O Deva Dasyante Yagya Bhavita Tair Dittan Ha Pradhaya Go Yo Bhunte Stena Vecha. The devatas, please, with the sacrifice, will destroy your desired enjoyment. He who enjoys what is given by the devatas without offering to them is indeed a thief. So here it is mentioned, to make this point clearer, he speaks the fault of not performing this activity. He who enjoys what is given by the devatas, such as food through the rain, without giving anything to them through performance of Pancha Mahayagya and other rites, is a thief. Now, what is the Pancha Mahayagya? It is mentioned. The five great sacrifices consist of sacrifice of pitras, worship of devatas, recitation of Vedas, feeding humans, and feeding other living being entities. Oh, these are the Pancha Mahayagyas for Pancha Mahapap. It is Pancha Shunu, it is called. It's not Pancha Mahayagya actually. Here it is mentioned. Those who eat food remnants of yagyas such as Vishwa Deva Yagya become freed from all sins caused by five types of violence to living entities. The five violent acts, Pancha Shunu, yes, it is here, is described. The grahasthas does not enjoy surf by commission of the five violent acts towards other living entities caused using the mortar, grinding stone, the stove, the broom, and the water pot. So this is in the Vaishnava Smriti Shastras. So because we commit this panchishuna, the five kinds of sinful activities to other living beings, regularly there are these pancha maha yagyas which are mentioned to counteract this. So in the traditional Varnashram, they have to do, those who are in the Grahastashram. But by chanting Hare Krishna, we need not perform all these other yagyas, which are the Karma Kanda portion of the yagyas, because the chanting itself is the most purifying act. I hope it is clear. Any other questions, any other clarification anyone has? Okay, so we will stop here. Srila Prabhupada ki jai, Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur ki jai, Sri Harinam Chintamani ki jai, Hare Krishna.